أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إن شئت سهلا. سبحانك ربنا لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام عليكم brothers and sisters and welcome. Inshallah, today we're gonna be talking about some of the ways and the means to help the believer to bring himself close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be with Allah, to run to Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنِّي لَكُم مِّنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُّبِينٌ. Run away to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the ma'iyya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are two kind of ma'iyya. To be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everybody, every creature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, Allah is with him or with it, as to provide, as to look after, as to give life, as to answer him when he is in trouble. This is the ma'iyya, to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the right of the creation, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them, and Allah does not forget about them. So that is why if a non-believer, if an atheist or agnostic, a non-believer, ask Allah for rizq, Allah will provide for him. If he work hard, Allah is gonna give him what he work for. So if he is in trouble, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, حتى إذا كنتم في الفلك وجرينا بهم بريح طيبة وفرحوا بها جاءتهم ريح عاصف. When we are in the ship, everybody enjoying the journey. As long as the storm start, everybody cry for help. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come to their help, even though they reject Allah after that. When they are safe and secure, they turn back to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To worship the dunya, to worship the money, to worship the fame, to worship the greed, to worship idols, to worship human being, to worship even prophets. So that is the ma'iyya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give to everybody. But we are talking about a special kind of ma'iyya. Ma'iyya means the word ma'a. Inna allaha ma'a al-muttaqeen. Wallahu inna allaha ma'a al-sabirin. The word ma'a means Allah is with. So that is the meaning of ma'iyya. So when we talk about this kind of ma'iyya, special kind of ma'iyya for the believers, for those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the kind of ma'iyya that we are talking about. Special kind of ma'iyya to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to find the sweetness of iman. To find the beauty of your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the kind of being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We talked enough about that. Today we're gonna talk about two of the ways and the means to make the believer always with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always feel he is in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first one is iman and continuously doing the salah, the zakah, and the other obligation, believing in Allah and his messenger, and always help the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وقال الله إني معكم. That is in Surah المائدة, verse 12. وقال الله إني معكم. Allah said, I am with you. What are the conditions? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَئِنْ أَقَمْتُمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Number one is to keep up your prayer, your salah. وَآتَيْتُمُ الزَّكَاةِ, to give your charity. وَآمَنْتُمْ بِرُسُلِي, to believe in my messengers. وَعَزَّرْتُمُوهُمْ, and to aid and to help them. So that is the first ways and means, the first qualification for the believer to enjoy the ma'iyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you believe, then Allah become your sight, Allah become your ear, Allah become your hand, Allah become your legs. Allah will be always in your mind. So to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to naturally to believe in the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that faith will be tested. That kind of relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will test how serious we are when we say we believe. That is why the Bedouin or the Arabs, when they believe, when they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they recited the Shahada, and they got so excited and they said, Alhamdulillah, amanna. Qalat al-A'rabu, amanna. Thank God, now we are believers. Qul lam tu'minu, walakin qulu aslamna. Not yet. The faith to say I'm a believer, it doesn't come only by Shahada. That faith has to be manifested. When you give out of your time for Allah, when you give out of your money for Allah, regardless how much you love and how much you work for your money, when you sacrifice yourself for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you do not relax, when you have to challenge, when you have to be challenged, and when you are in a time that you have to speak the truth, you got to go for it. وَآمَنْتُمْ بُرُسُلِ وَعَزَّرْتُمُهُمْ. So, قُلْ لَمْ تُؤْمِنُوا وَلَكِنْ قُولُوا أَسْلَمْنَا. Now you are Muslims. Because you do the shahada, you do the salah that everybody see, but iman is deeper than that. Iman, when you face a hardship, when you face a challenge, are you gonna commit yourself to that or not? So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ألف لام ميم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Do people think that they're gonna be lifted or left just to say we believe without being tested? So that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran, إن تنصروا الله ينصركم وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. How to give victory to Allah, how to support Allah? By supporting the truth, by supporting the values, the virtues, the obligation, the qiyam, the value, the Islamic values, by standing for the truth, speaking and supporting justice. So that is, إِن تَنْصُرُوا اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ. Allah himself doesn't need any help from us. But we are trying to show how much you are committed to the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the first attribute, the first way, the first help, the first qualification to gain the ma'iyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to say, I am with Allah. Allah is with me. The second one is really very interesting. And that is to look for good people to be with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. O you who believe, be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always think about your maker, about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Always try to associate yourself with the truthful people, with the people who are committed to the truth. And it's very amazing really to know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose the word صادقين. Why Allah doesn't say وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّائِمِينَ, وكونوا مع المصلين، وكونوا مع المعتمرين، وكونوا مع قارئ القرآن، وكونوا مع المنفقين، لا الصادقين. Why? Because the word is صدق is the cornerstone for every virtue after that. If there is no صدق, the prayer is not accepted. The umrah and the hajj is not accepted. The nafaqa doesn't mean anything. So that is why the صدق. When a man came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, يا رسول الله, أيكون المؤمن جبانا؟ Can a believer become coward or be coward? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, yes. There are some people who fear death, who do not want to get hurt. Yes. أيكون المؤمن بخيلا؟ Can a believer become miser, stingy? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, yes. Then the man asked, يا رسول الله, أيكون المؤمن كذابا؟ قال لا. Can a believer become a liar? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no. Because lying and the faith cannot coexist, cannot be together in the heart of the believer. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. Because the صدق, that is what you're gonna be tested with. Are you gonna speak the truth? Are you gonna dare to stand for justice and to speak what is right, what is good, what is godly, even though you might get yourself in trouble? That is the challenge. That what makes the believer find the sweetness of being in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So always, brothers and sisters, you want to be with Allah and Allah is with you. You want to find the sweetness of Iman. You want to find the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Allah is with you. Allah is in your right. Allah is in your hand, in your left. Allah is gonna front of you. Allah is behind you. Allah is above you. So if you want to feel you are surrounded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by Allah's care and Allah's attention, and Allah remember you all the time, you got to look for good relationship. You got to look for good surrounding, good friendship, good companionship. You have to select them. You have to make sure that they are kind of people that, as mentioned, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء كحامل المسك ونافخ الكير. Like they say, tell me who is your friend, I'm gonna tell you who you are. So, المرء على دين خليله. You are same way like your friend. If he is good, you're gonna be good. If he is bad and lousy, you're gonna be the same. If he's gonna be a man or a woman of the mosque and the Quran and the good behavior and all of that, you're gonna be the same. So that is why, brothers and sisters, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء كحامل المسك ونافخ الكير. The likeness, the example of the good friend, the good friendship, and the bad friendship is like the one who is selling musk, you know, that fragrance, the cologne, and the other side, the other one is the hamil al-kir, nafikh al-kir. Nafikh al-kir means the blacksmith, with all due respect to all of them. So if you go with somebody who is selling musk, you're gonna buy from, you know, or you can at least get to, you smell good, your clothes will smell good, your body, everything will be good. But if you go with the blacksmith, especially in the olden days, or where the workshop is, and, you know, putting the iron in the fire and the refuse and the smell bad, you're gonna get your clothes burned, or at least you smell bad. You need to take a shower. That is why the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam always emphasize on surrounding. المرء على دين خليله. This is what they say. فلينظر أحدكم من يخالل. You are the same way like your friend. الطيور على أشكالها تقع. The similar bird flock together.
The good people, they are together. The bad people are together. The people who go to the bar, they are together. The people who go to the mosque, they are together. They know one another, and they are introduced to each other. So that is why it's been said, khayrul ashabi, the best of all friends. Who are they? Man idha nasita Allah dhakkara. So beautiful. The one that is when you forget about Allah. If you miss your dhuhr prayer, you are busy with him the whole day, he will come to say, you so and so. You forget to do your dhuhr prayer. If you are too late and you want to sleep, you say, no, you didn't pray Aisha. You didn't make the witr. إِذَا نَسِيْتَ اللَّهَ ذَكَّرَكَ. When you commit something wrong, when you misbehave, all due respect, he's going to tell you, I do not like the way you are, because that is not good. You are a Muslim, you are a believer. You should give the best example for your faith. You have to behave nicely as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. إِذَا نَسِيْتَ اللَّهَ ذَكَّرَكَ. وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ اللَّهَ أَعَانَكَ. When you remember Allah, he is so proud of you. He's going to help you. He's going to do his best to help you in your cause. So that is why, brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ. If you are in this kind of surrounding, you obey Allah, you obey the messenger of Allah, you do what is right. In this dunya, you look for good people to go with and to spend some time with, to accept them as your friend. Look at what is coming after that. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. You're gonna be resurrected with those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the pleasure to be in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who are they? النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. You're gonna be with the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're gonna be with the truthful people. You're gonna be with the shaheed who testify for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even sacrifice himself for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. And that the word is صالحين. They are good in themselves and they are making everything around them good. So they are صالح and مصلح. صالح for himself, for his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also مصلح means when he sees something wrong, he corrects it. Always he stand and take an action when something go against what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. أولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. What kind of people are they? وحسن أولئك رفيقا. What a great companionship. What a great friendship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the talent and the humility so we can reconsider what we are doing and try to live our life the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy with. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Thank you very much for listening. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.